Big Musso, back with another gay reaction. My gay neighbors have been mowing and shit, fucking up my gay content, but I think they might be done. If not, fuck it. We're fucking ghetto anyways. Very lo-fi. We will upgrade at some point and be more like the other gay reactors you're used to. But right now we're grimy, and that's fine. What the fuck are we reacting to? Oh yeah. We are reacting to Nestle, I Am the South. Now Nestle, you may know, is the person who ghost wrote, or at least helped to be a ghostwriter for Benzino and his rap Elvis diss to Eminem recently. And I know Nestle from rapmusic.com, which is sort of my origins of learning how to not be gay as a rapper. There's forums there. There was a particular subforum called Audio MC Hookups that was the most popping, and people would post up their shit. They had battles, tournaments, shit like that. I discovered it when I was like 12 or 13. I was younger than a lot of them boys. I didn't start to like make a name for myself till it was a little later, a little past this prime. But still some of us, a few of us at grindergohome.com and those forums, if you want to argue with me or help me argue against the gays that are there, you can do that. But Nestle was a big name there. I remember people holding this track in high regard. I never actually heard it. I knew Ness was pretty dope. And actually, Nimi Hendrix is the director of this video. And he was Nimrod on the boards. And he was kind of sort of a Drake in that he stirred the pot, you know. He was a main character, but he was good at rapping and shit, and he became a video director. I don't know what he's doing now, but he also had he took some big L's, for sure. And then, Flawzilla, as I've mentioned, he was on those boards as Marcus Black. I remember him from there, and my boy Mota, who was Damon Ortiz then, he goes by Nakeem Muhammad now, I guess. He found God and shit, which that ain't gay. That's cool. Anyway, yeah, it's been a lot of rap music shit popping off, like rapmusic.com legacy shit as far as Ness being the ghostwriter, which shocked me for Benzino, and then Flawed taking out gay Ryan Upchurch, which I didn't really know much about Upchurch. Still don't really. Just knew that he was a gay white country rapper, pretty gay. Anyways, let's get into Nestle. I Am the South. See if it's gay. I remember that logo, that SS Secret Society, I think, logo from Nimrod.
So like, they really don't know we exist down here, dog. Like, I was in New York for this little video shoot, you know what I'm saying? And this dude had this camera, you know what I'm saying? He was getting interviews from, like, all the unsigned rappers and whatnot. So I walks up on him, like, hey, what up with the verse, man? Mm-hmm. He's like, all right, where you from? Like, GA, sure, gave his little look, but he was like, all right, tell me where you're from.
Oh, yeah. Obviously, he's from Atlanta, opening with a little skit. A little gay, but we'll allow it.
Spit your verse, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, yeah, I'm from GA, find me on Twitter, blah, blah, blah. I spit my verse.
Right.
Nigga holds the camera to the side like, okay, I'm going to cut it on for real this time.
See how they do us, brother. Yeah. That's just because we from the South, brother. They're going to recognize it.
They're definitely
going to
recognize
it.
That's bitch that, though. Right?
Pretty fire, not gonna lie. Basketball shorts with a hoodie, cool, fire. Flip-flops, any kind of sandals, flip-flops on a man is gay. I don't care if you got socks, don't got socks. I don't care if you chilling. I don't give a fuck. It's gay. That's just me. I saw him talking about Twista on Facebook recently. Twista's verse on, I think, Joyner's album, which I haven't got to yet. But saying he had a fire verse on there. And I can tell there's some Twista influence. But it's funny, he does pop, he's probably mostly trolling, partially trolling, but he does troll about Eminem on there sometimes. And I don't know, it's just funny. When you all rap fast, it's cool. When Eminem raps fast and does it better than you, it's gay. It ain't gay, dog. I mean, that's not saying he's never rapped fast and it was gay. The Killer remix is gay. He gave that up. He's done it a few times. But by and large, when he's really going in, the Chloroseptic remix, whatever the fuck, Not Alike. Not Alike is one of the illest shits ever, one of the illest flows I ever heard, illest songs I ever heard. Murders that. You know he does it better than you can, even if you do it very well and very dope. Not trying to take away from you. You're dope. This is cool. I'll stop jabbering. We'll get back into it. God is getting red on the card night, and we gon' take a vital to the head like a firefight. Fuck so hard, I step my tennis. Don't fall in and I'm back in the building. Dark in the devil, air cap for the beat, step back, but I spin it like a trap with a million. I will do not offend me, don't go joining all my city, bro. I focus, I get a little flow, you know I got it in me. The focus on this doses, we've been rolling on a 10-speed home. We grown honest black. I like how he transitions from the slower melodic shit that you might think of more traditionally with the South. But he still bars you up, and he still cares about the craft. And then he transitions so smoothly into the fast rap shit. It's dope. Pocahontas with me, mine stay growing. I stay open, intelligent. If you guys ain't know this trick, I do it. Cause I am. Okay, you break in the Southern stereotypes by and large with your lyricism and your technical abilities. Not that there's no one from the South that can do that, but I'm just saying. But the hook is very of the time, obviously very repetitive. I am the South a million times with the I am the South. Yeah, I'm not feeling that. Not terrible though. Just being honest, a little gay. I will say, I mean, there's nothing wrong with this. His voice is like just seeing him. And I feel like I remember him rapping a little more deep voice. Maybe, you know, like I was aware of all the names and some I got into from rap music I'm talking about, but some I just didn't get into. But I knew he was highly respected and I knew I listened at least enough to know he was dope, and he is dope. But I was expecting more of like a deep voiced rap style, kind of like me, like kind of like extra not gay. But his is a little more high pitched than I would suspect, just from like his frame and his appearance and whatnot.
You're my love, you're my angel, you're the woman of my dream.
Well, okay, we're getting pretty gay. To be honest, I thought that was a tranny at first, probably mostly the hair, but you know, strong shoulders. I can see she's a pretty lady. She's nothing wrong with her. Just at first, I was like, what? But that aside, this is gay, breaking down into this doo-wop, soulful, twist, gay shit that's going on here. I don't like it. I don't care if you're trying to show you can sing and do other things. You gayed up a good song. I was kind of vibing, and now it's gay.
I want to thank you for waiting patiently. Daddy's home to stay.
Woo! Got real gay on that high note, bro. yikes. Why'd you do that for? So it's cool overall. I mean, you could tell he's dope when he's getting into it, but I think this was obviously his like big swing at like mainstream success, and you can kind of tell, you know. I mean, I give him credit. It's a far bigger swing than I ever took, but like at the same time, that's what comes with it. When you try to have mass appeal, you get a little gay, a little gay. I'm a pioneer, but I belong with the best. I put down my Adidas, cause every range of falters when you judge them by perfection. Homie, I'm a fire breather, and I'm the only exception. And I ain't even trying to say that I'm a pioneer, but I belong with the best. I put down my Adidas, cause every range of falters when you judge them by perfection. Homie, I'm a fire breather, and I'm the only exception.
Kept me, red clay ministry, Dutch Chevy pulpit, master of the ceremony, enslaved to the rhythms, shackled to the grind, so we swing low like chariots, underground like Harriet, the last to hold the torch, let us show y'all how to carry it, stop throwing modium to the podium, I can feel your sodium, your mind's like nines, automatic, never loading them, keep thinking we just cotton fields, and you end up copper field. AT alien in orbit, I like the beats like Norbit. Obese where I leave a crease, where you breathing a snore bit. Heavy on the mind, Brooklyn Levy with the rhyme. We flow steadily like the crime rate, deadlifting your mind state. Do you understand the words coming out my mouth, or do I gotta translate? I am the South.
Okay, it got weirdly political and stuff, and like, just like playing the race card real hard, like it just came out of nowhere. I was gonna say like, hey, they got all kinds of people in this, white people, black people, everybody people, probably gay people, whatever, it's cool. And then all of a sudden it was like, yo, racism, racism's gay, I'm the motherfucking South, that means I'm extra against, I don't know. Just it's like, it's fine to do that. It just, there's like, the song's a party vibe, I'm chilling on the corner talking about how I spit so dope, but people don't know, these DJs or whoever the fuck he's talking about playing me, and then it's a vibe, I guess, it's a party jam, and then it breaks down in the middle, and it's a gay doo-wop love song, comes back to the hook, which I wasn't a fan of, and then transitions into this shit, and it's just like, what? It's a little scattered. It's a little scattered. Anyway, that got gay, had potential to not be gay, but like I said, mainstream swing, he really swung. He hit all the notes. The last part, he started really rapping again and was kind of doing like a spoken word shit. And I'm sure there were some bars I wasn't catching because I was thrown off by the sudden switch of the vibe and it getting all gay. And that's cool. I like that he decided to start breaking it down, spitting. But it was like, I need some drums in there, man. Just rapping over pianos and shit. It's like some Walk on Water M vibes. So it's just like not quite hitting for me. Maybe I just don't get it because I'm white. And I don't have a soul because of melanin, and I'm subhuman, and I learned about it from Nick Cannon. So that's probably it. It's probably the best song of all time. I mean, if you get to write for Benzino, you probably are the illest of all time. Anyways, tune in next time. See what's gay. Moose came with your mom doing gruesome things. Passing blunts like LeBron about to do Kareem. Want the smoke with some bong and some hookah fiends. Make you wish it was a dream, yo. Where's the women at? I'm pimping at your Timothy.
stupid ass a bitch. If you can't afford no Similac, then them is not your kids. If I spit a rap, that shit's a fact. Now spit it back, you little bitch. I